मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टैंडर्ड 12 अकाउंटेंसी ओके सो इन दिस वीडियो वी गोइंग टू डिस्कस यूनिट 6 कंज्यूमर प्रोडक्शन चैप्टर 16 कंज्यूमरिज्म ओके सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय कंज्यूमरिज्म वी लर्नड ऑलरेडी इन द लास्ट वीडियो सो वंस अगेन व्हाट इज कंज्यूमरिज्म कंज्यूमरिज्म इज एन अटेम्प्ट टू एनहांस द राइट्स एंड पावर्स ऑफ बायर रिलेशनशिप टू द सेलर्स ओके सो why we need for consumer protection okay why we need for consumer protection though consumer is said to be the king of entire business sphere we know that consumer is said to be the king of entire business world so his interests are virtually neglected so next point health hazard is never considered consumer health hazard is never considered then third one quality is sacrificed quality of goods or is sacrificed then fourth one Variety of performance has no meaning. So, this in such case, a complex consumer production remains a vital importance. So, next there are the three parties involved in the sphere of business transaction. Number one, the government, business, and the consumers. And the consumers. So, let's see the what are the role of business in the consumer production. Then what is the role of government in the consumer production? And next we going to see role of the consumer production. Okay. So what is the role of the consumer in consumer production? Next we going to see role of business in consumer production. So business enterprise should be to the following towards protecting the consumers. So first one, avoidance of price hike. What is meant by avoidance of price hike? That means the business enterprise should desist from hiking the price in the context of the acute shortage of goods and articles. Next point, avoidance of hoarding. What is meant by avoidance of hoarding? That means the business enterprise should allow the business to flow normally. So it should not indulge in hoarding and black marketing to earn maximum possible profit in the short term at the cost of consumers. Cost of consumer, that is called the avoidance of hoarding. Next point, third point, guarantees of good quality. What is meant by guarantees of good quality? That means the business enterprise should not give the false warranty. Okay, should not give the false warranty of the for the products. That is called the guarantees of good quality. Then it should ensure the supply of good quality only. Okay. So next point, product of information. Product of information. So what is in the product of information? Business enterprise should disclose correct and complete and accurate information. Okay. So accurate information about the product. So that is size, quality, quantity, then substance and substance of use, then side effects, precautions, weight, exchange and the mode of application, etc. That is called the product information. So next point, truth in advising. So in consumer protection act, so role of business is main one, truth in advising. What is meant by truth in advising? That means the business enterprise should convey the false and untrue bogus information relating to the product through the advertisement in media. Okay, so and thus the mislead to the consumers. The next point, sixth one, production from the hazard. What is meant by production from the hazard? That means the business enterprise should not market the product which is potentially hazardous and harmful. So it should test the safety and product before they are marketed. So as regards food items, business enterprise should withdraw the spoiled and contaminated food items. So contaminated food items means box items. Okay, you know that. Okay, next point, money refund guarantee. What is meant by money refund guarantee? That means where the product before the defective business enterprises should replace it with the new one or refund the purchase price. Okay, so if the product causes injury or harm to the consumers, it should reimburse the expenditure done by the consumers concerned. Okay, the next point, last point, consumer grievance. Consumer, what is meant by consumer grievance? So consumer grievance means where the business enterprises have customer care department, you should handle the grievances of consumer immediately. If any problem, we can to handle the consumer grievances immediately or within a definite time frame. Okay, that is called a consumer grievances. So once again, what is the role of business in consumer protection? First point, avoidance of price hike. Second point, avoidance of hauling. Third point, guarantees of good quality. Fourth point, product information. Fifth point, truth in advising. And sixth point, protection from the hazard. And seventh point, money refunded guarantee. And the eighth one, consumer grievances. So next we are going to see what is the role of government in Consumer Protection Act. So you know that since the most of the consumers, including academically educated or illiterate about the rights and the hensiopathy. Okay, so the government should assure an active role in safeguarding the consumers. Okay, so next point, government, both the central and the state government, and the have brought out their number of legislation to protect the interest of the consumers across the country. Next, we are going to discuss role of consumers in the consumer protection. What is the role of in consumer protection? So you know that, so ultimately is the consumer who alone can put an end to all the unethical trade practices. Okay, so business enterprises may break the course of government, may rest the conduct to the more inaction of laws, and do little to the practice of the consumer. Okay, in this content, consumer law to be the vigilant and organize themselves. Okay, the movement of concentrated actions. Movement of concentrated actions. Next, we are going to see, discuss about activation of consumer action council. What are the activations of consumer action councils? Well, now we are going to see point wise. So first point, consumer action councils established at village levels. Okay, consumer action councils established at the village level should educate the consumers of the right. Okay, educate the consumer right. Then second point, it should regulate the business enterprises according to the rules of the industry. It regulates the business enterprise according to the rules of the industry. Okay, so third point, voluntary consumers groups. Voluntary consumers. Okay, so voluntary means what is meant by voluntary? Voluntary means people who want to voluntary work. Okay, so voluntary consumers groups should provide. So voluntary consumers groups should provide the information so as to educate the consumers. Educate the consumers on matters affecting them through the media. Media means TV or television. Okay, television or a website like that. Okay, next one. It should organize the movement against the malpractice. Okay, of manufacturers and traders. It should organize the movement against of the malpractice. Who will do the malpractice? Of the manufacturers and the traders. Then fifth point, consumer cooperatives need to be strengthened. In activation of consumer action councils, consumer cooperative need to be strengthened. And sixth point, there should be testing the laboratories at each district to test the purity of the goods. We have to test the purity of the goods. Next, seventh point, consumer protection agencies should take the necessary steps to investigate the consumer complaints. Okay, so we have to investigate the consumer complaints and the grievances and arrange to forward them to the correct form. Okay, the next point, eighth point, consumer groups should contact the legislators. Consumer groups should contact the legislators to raise the consumer issues. So what are the consumer issues? So we have to should contact the legislator in assembly and parliament. Okay, the ninth point, voluntary consumer organization should publicize the malpractices. So voluntary consumer organizations should publish the malpractices of the manufacturer and malpractices and traders to the media. Okay, so voluntary consumer organization should publicize the malpractices of manufacturers and traders by media. The next one, it should take the initiation to report such sufficiency and authority who let the offender to go scot-free of the follow enforcement agencies. Okay, so these are the points of activation of consumer councils. So these are the actions, activation of councils. Okay, activation of consumer protection councils. Okay, so I hope you all understand these 10 points. Okay, thank you very much.